Obeying the Gospel, March 5th, Trustworthiness of the Scriptures, Part 2. For I delivered to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that He was buried, that He was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, 1 Corinthians 15:3-4. When we speak of the New Testament record of Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, there are three links in the chain of trustworthiness. First, there were the prophecies of the Messiah in the Old Testament. Second, Jesus fulfilled those prophecies with strict accuracy. And third, the New Testament writers reported the facts about Jesus' fulfillment of prophecy, again, with strict accuracy. At each step of the way, the process depended on faithfulness to the historical events behind the gospel. In between steps 1 and 2, there was a gap of several centuries, and this adds to the credibility of Jesus' messiahship. When Jesus fulfilled the Hebrew prophecies, those predictions had been known publicly for at least 200 years. The Septuagint, the Greek translation of the Old Testament, was begun around 250 BC. So even if none of the prophecies were any older than that, and most were much older, the prophets could not possibly have known that far in advance what Jesus would do. Yet virtually everything Jesus did matched up precisely with these prophecies. But what about the gap between steps 2 and 3? Here we need a gap as small as possible, and that's exactly what we've got. If the New Testament writings had been made 2 or 3 centuries after Jesus lived, we might argue that their presentation of Jesus was legendary and not historical. But the gap between the events and the reporting of those events was not 2 or 3 centuries, it was only a few years. Paul's writings are the earliest, beginning as early as AD 50 or 51, but even the last of the New Testament writings were completed during the first century, while eyewitnesses to the recorded events were still living. So as we said in yesterday's reading, the New Testament writings are trustworthy. We may reject the gospel as being a doctrine we're not interested in, but we may not, if we're historians, claim that Jesus never said or did the things that are attributed to him. As Pierre Benoit wrote, "The Christians may not have been interested in history, but they were certainly interested in the historical. The preachers of the new faith may not have wanted to narrate everything about Jesus, but they certainly did not want to relate anything that was not real."